How are you thinking about the ethical way in which these companies do adopt and let this generative AI run loose on their own proprietary data?
Thanks, Carolyn. So overall, we are really thinking about generative AI as a tool for good, but what it's showing to be is that companies are learning so much more about their consumer base and allowing their consumers to spend time showing trends in a much more vulnerable way, which we find fascinating. The way that Klarna is engaging with their customers on a new level and a way that they're gathering the data to prove that there are ways to use and harness the data to really provide better products and services to consumers from a lending perspective and then from a spend perspective. And it seems as though consumers are really engaging with the AI in a way that just seems so much more real and authentic than they ever have.
If financial conditions are getting tighter and it's hard out there for founders, are venture capitalists being pushed into making AI-related investments that in any other economy or environment they just wouldn't normally make because of all of the hype?
Overall, what's so interesting about the VCs in the space making AI bets is that so many companies were already utilizing AI functionality as a way to harness data and then use insights of that artificial intelligence data to build better products. But what's funny is that VCs today are having a hard time determining what's actually going to make money at. So some of these companies are really taking a push towards open sourcing the technology versus actually making it a repeatable subscription-based business. And I think that's the big debate within VC world is what's going to actually make money.
I'm going to jump on that. What's actually going to make money? You invest in SpaceX. When is SpaceX going to make money? Is SpaceX ever going to IPO or spin off Starlink?
Well, overall, SpaceX does have a lot of cash, and they do make money by way of the Starlink spaceships and satellite services, because overall, what's fascinating is a lot of people across the world, now that it's in every continent, are spending money on Starlink, and it's generating a ton of revenue. But what we do think is that Starlink is big enough as a business that they could spin it off eventually, right? And I do see an independent IPO. If we just see that Musk were to integrate generative AI into SpaceX, it might just be a done deal, though, if that were the case.
Mm-hmm. Talk to us a little bit about tomorrow's IPOs today, which is what Manhattan Ventures Partners' sort of tagline is. You're all about the secondary market in many ways. And just what is the secondary market like for an Elon-backed company? I mean, whether it be the vision of X, whether it's SpaceX, or whether it's any of the companies you have in your portfolio right now, are people willing and able and wanting to buy on the secondary market?
So right now, it is absolutely fascinating because you're getting to see that the secondary market is driving the true value of every single private company. And overall, I think it's the real indicator for where investors are willing to buy and shareholders are looking to sell. So I think we've never seen a more clear opportunity to dive into the secondary market. And what's fascinating is companies themselves are coming to us and coming to many others in the secondary market space and saying, we don't really know what the value of our company is in the current market because we last raised a big round of funding in mid-2021. And so the top indicator, the leading indicator we're seeing is the secondary market to price companies at their true asset value. So it's fascinating to see it, and we ourselves are seeing the opportunities are growing exponentially in a way that the companies are thankful that there's a real indicator that goes beyond a new round of primary financing.
I mean, isn't it, Ed, at the moment, when we're ever talking about a primary round of financing, it tends to be AI-related in some way, shape, or form?
It does. Yeah, I think that's the part that we all want to understand better, Andrea, which is just forget a news cycle or a hype cycle. What are you doing to wake up each day and say, okay, here's where we're going to deploy capital. Here's our plan for 2023. Here's our, you know, what I'm trying to understand is what is driving investment thesis for VCs right now?
What's interesting about the thesis-driven approach with all VCs is that all the companies that are approaching us and we are approaching them for capital raising is that they're really looking to preserve the valuation that they last had. And it is almost a valuation at all stake, at all, you know, permutations of a valuation. So what's interesting is that from a thesis perspective, we're determining whether or not to invest in companies that have investor sweeteners involved in the next round of funding, or maybe it is that the best entry price is that secondary market value. Maybe that next round of funding is, you know, cluttered with really strong investor provisions that allow for protection and upside. And so I think a lot of investors in our space, especially in the growth and late stage, are determining whether or not that next round of funding is attractive enough to go into relative to secondary.
Andrea, after Linda Yaccarino news came on Twitter, did that bump the valuation that you've been seeing for Twitter? I know it's part of your portfolio post it going private. Is that something that you think is getting a clearer destination and getting investors more interested?
Having Linda involved, we think, is a very strong indicator of where we believe Elon is playing the C-level shuffle, what we like to call, right? So bringing in the strong adults in the room to really bring in a background in advertising and media, which overall, that is what Twitter really is focused on, right? Advertising, media, and content-driven. So I think it's a strong signal. Linda is a phenomenal executive with an incredible background that I think many of us in the industry are very impressed with their ability to land. So I think generally we consider that a massive positive.